Okay, we're ready to start our conference with the Kansas Jayhawks. We've got one participant up here, Aniya Thomas and Zakiyah is here. Zakiyah Franklin, we didn't get the name until later. It's my fault. I apologize. And Brandon Schneider, you are the coach, so we'll let you start with an opening statement.
Zakiyah Franklin. I thought we competed a lot harder in the second half. Thought OU played with a lot more juice than us in the first half. You just can't give a team 35 extra possessions. Getting out rebounded 14 just in the first half. Give up 18 offensive rebounds for the game. That's not a formula for winning.
Okay, we'll take questions for our student athletes or for coach. Just let us know. Got a question on the front? Mike Stein.
Zach Blair from the Lawrence Journal World. Aniya, the fourth quarter, you had 13 points, all 13 of your points in the fourth quarter. You guys closed within six. What's the mentality at that point as you feel it getting closer and closer?
The mentality was just an attack, and we needed a spark to like start scoring. We didn't have much time. We were trying to get us back into it. We could get everybody involved. We just needed a spark, and that was a spark. But I wish it was more.
We got a question on the front row.
Coach, so this is one of the first tournaments that's in person, and after having a great season, regular season, but really the postseason is just beginning. How does it feel to be in Kansas City and seeing everybody come out and support?
It was a great atmosphere. We love having the tournament in Kansas City. Disappointed that we're not going to be here longer.
We have a question on the front row, right?
Brandon Jordan, the Topeka Avenue Journalist. What do the next couple of days look like for you guys as you wait for Selection Sunday?
That's a good question. We were not planning on going home, but that's the case now. So I think when we get back to the hotel here as a staff, we'll meet and discuss it. It does give the players a little bit of time to rest, as we know that Monday, Tuesday, depending on where we go in the bracket, will be extremely hectic days.
Got a question on the front.
Zakiyah, what do you think was the difference for you guys in the second quarter after that 13-3 start?
Honestly, what Coach said, we wanted to come out with more juice. We felt like they came out more juice the first half. And just wanted to stay aggressive and get off to a good start.
Got a question on here.
Lila Bromberg with the Kansas City Star for either Aniya or Zakiyah. What change in that, you mentioned a little bit, but just in that, second quarter, just making two of your guys' final 14 attempts of the first half, what changed with what you guys were seeing defensively from them?
Defensively, it was pretty much the same thing. They played the same way. Like I said before, we just want to come out and be aggressive and get the ball in the paint, get paint touches. Hopefully that does something good for us.
We had a greater sense of urgency in the second half. Basically, we knew we were supposed to come out and play harder. They came out and played harder in the first. We did, but we picked it up. That's how we should have played the whole game, but it still happens. But we just had a greater sense of urgency. We came out hard. I wish it was like, as I said earlier, I wish it was more we could have done. But the first half, just lost in the first half. We just had to go harder in the second.
John, front row.
Lily Wachowski, KDJH. Coach, how proud are you of this team for what they've accomplished in the regular season?
I'm extremely proud of them. I think of our eight losses, of our nine losses, eight were to teams who were projected four seed or better. So that's top 16. prior to today, we hadn't lost a game in 6 weeks to anybody who wasn't in the top 10. Our only other loss was at K-State when they were in the top 25. So, I'm proud of what these guys have achieved. I mean, Tyler Jackson broke a 30-year-old record today with 90 blocks. She had, prior to today, 304 deflections on the season. So there's a lot of things that can be celebrated with this group, whether it be the team or in particular individuals. But I know that it stings today, and hopefully that will be fuel for not wanting to feel this very quickly in the NCAA tournament.
Caroline Soro, University of Kansas. Coach, what is that mindset heading into the NCAA tournament? You're going to use this loss to kind of fuel the push here?
Well, I think we have to look at the film, and we have to understand that there was some self-inflicted wounds, in particular in the first half, in regards to rebounding. You know, rebounding has been a real predictor for our success this season. And when we've not been competitive on the glass, most generally we come up short.
I think we have a question on the front.
Yeah, Brandon, what's the challenge that they present when you're in the second half, you're able to finally shut them down on the perimeter, and then they're using that motion to getting those back cuts and getting those layups?
Well, I thought we, credit them for, again, just the energy and juice that they played with. I thought everything they did today, they did it really hard. They cut hard, they drove it hard, they sprinted hard in transition, they went after offensive rebounds and loose balls hard. I'd have to look at the film, and I feel like we made some errors and did not rotate defensively, as we would have liked on some of the layups that you're referencing.
Any other questions for Coach or our student athletes? Don't want to career.
Andy Bitts, Bloomings Rising. Coach, you talked about the difference in terms of rebounding and the offensive rebound. You turned a 12-1 offensive rebound deficit at the half to pretty much even before the very last few possessions. What was the difference in the second half where you were able to get on the offensive rebounding a lot better?
Play harder and decide that you want to be a competitor.
Anything else? Okay, guys, good luck to you.